वेलकम बैक, वेलकम टू ऑप्टिमाइजर चैनल। दिस इज सेशन 3 ऑफ पावर डिज़ाइन। सो इन फर्स्ट सेशन वी हैव कवर्ड बेसिक कमांड्स ऑफ पावर डिज़ाइन। इन सेकंड डिज़ाइन वी हैव सीन सम सैम्पल एंड सिंपल पावर डिज़ाइन। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी our in our third session, that is a little bit more complicated parts. Okay, so let us start. So in this session we are going to see these two parts, and after that we'll in next session we will see other parts also. Okay, so let us start. So if you just see as already we have discussed in last session, so two steps we have to finalize, that in which direction we have to start, either x, y, z, and in how many steps we have to cover that part. Okay, so if you just see our first step will be this rectangular base, second step will be this, what we can say, this profile that you have to pad, okay, by this distance, and third step is this rectangle slot which is there. And last one is this hole, which is at the middle. Okay, so total four different steps are required for this part. Okay, so I'm going to start from this direction. First of all, I'm going to draw this rectangular plate or rectangular body, and I am going to pad it by 50. Then secondly, I'm going to draw this profile and pad it. Okay, so let us start. So coming back to Catia. So go to start, sketcher, select this plane, then draw a rectangular like this. And here, if you just see 90 and total 50. So this one is 90 and this width is 15. And just click on this exit workbench and then it is 50. Okay, so this is our first step. Okay, so if you want to pad it in that direction, just click on reverse direction. So sketch this face. Now we are moving towards the next step, that is you have to draw this profile and then you have to pad it by 50. Okay, so let us start. So sketch, so just see. Okay, so it is like this, then horizontal line, then like this horizontal line, then it is going to meet here. Okay, then select this edge, this line, and make it coincident, and sketch, select this and make it, if you just see 40 plus 10, that is total 60. Okay, and total this one is 90, so remaining part is of only 15 mm. Just double click, make it 15. And this one is 40. Total height, if you just see the height, this one is 10, that you can mention here. And height, it is up to this, it is 15. So this height is 15. And this distance is 10 only. Similarly, this is 15 and this distance horizontal, this make it 15 only. Okay, and total height is not given. You can assume that if you consider a total height, it is not given. So we can consider this height as from this to this, we can consider this as 20 or 25, you can consider. Okay, now just click on exit workbench and pad it by reverse direction. We want it 50 here. Okay, so one more thing we have remaining, that so in this sketch only we can draw this circular hole of 510. Okay, so exactly at the center that you have to draw. So just here, so from this we can consider this as a 10 and this is phi 10 and from this it is 30. Just click on exit. Okay, now this is our what we can say second step. Now third step, just you have to select this face and then you have to draw this rectangle and just you have to pocket it. So there is one rectangle which will be like this, and this distance is 10, correct? This distance is again 10. And total depth, if you just see from this base, it is 5 mm only. From this base, this one is 5 mm only. Now we can pocket it up to last. Okay, so just pocket it up to last. Just click on OK. So this is third step, and last step is if you just zoom in, there is one hole which is at 30 mm and which is of 10 mm diameter. So sketch, select this face. And here from this it is 30 mm, from this is exactly at 25 because at center, and this one is 10, and just exit workbench and make it again. You can select a pocket up to last, click on OK. So this is our this part, okay, first part, okay. So I hope we have covered all the features of this. Yes. Now let us go to next, that of this part. Okay, so how to do this? Okay. So again, it is simple one. So from which direction, that direction you have to decide. So I'm going to draw in this direction. That means I'm going to draw this profile first. Okay, then I'm going to pad it. And after that, this extended portion we are going to cover it. Okay, so let us start with it. So almost how many steps are required here if you just go through it? So first step is this pad portion. Second step I'm going to draw, this is this pad, rectangular pad, and third one is this, and fourth one is I'm going to mirror this to this direction. Okay, so let us start. File, new part, okay, in sketch select this plane, and here you can select a centered rectangle which will be like this, and no, we missed it. Actually we don't require a rectangle. So sketch, select this top plane, and here we have to draw, this is first, this one is second, it should be concentric. Okay, now one rectangle will be there which is tangent to these two circles and which will be coincident with this. Make it coincident, and it should be tangent to this. Make it tangency. Okay, now you can trim all other portions. So just go to quick trim, double click here, just remove all unnecessary part, we don't require these things. Okay, so double click here, and if you just see, it is total 560 and this one is 530. And from this, if you just see, from this is this one is 75. So from this 75. Okay, so just exit workbench, and this is 12.5 mirror extent. Just click on OK. So this is what first step, and now second step just select this space or exit workbench. You can select a middle plane. So I'm going to select this middle plane like this, and here you have to again draw a rectangle like this. Okay, select this axis and this line and make it coincident. And so this you have to define. So the total height is 75 and this width is not given. You can consider this as an it is 25 again. Okay, so all widths are 25 only. This one is 75. Okay, just exit this, and now you can pad it by 30 mm mirror extent. So exactly at this we have pad it. So just make it 30 mirror extent. Just click on OK. Okay, so this will be our second part. Now third part is again whatever we have drawn here like that, only here it is. So just sketch on this space. Okay, so whatever we have drawn in first step, same process you have to follow here. First, second, then one rectangle. You can select a centered rectangle so that symmetry, you don't need to make it symmetry again. Okay, just make this and this coincident. Okay, just here you have to project this. So up to this only we are going to trim it, and just you can remove all other unnecessary part. Okay, again this should be tangent to this, make it tangent, and you can remove this. We don't require this. Okay, now just double click here and you can define the center distance. Just see, from this center to this center it is 135. So from what we can say, okay, no problem, this is total 135, and from this it is 135 minus 75. Okay, so it is around 60. So from this one it is around 60. So from this it is around 60. Am I right? 60. Yes, it is 60 only. Okay, now you can give a inner diameter, that is 530. So just go here and make it 30 and just exit workbench. Okay, and now you have to pad it by 25. Just click on OK. So it should be in reverse direction like this. Okay, now one shortcut we are going to use, that is mirror command. So just go to mirror. Okay, just you have to object the, you have to select this pad 3. Okay, and mirroring element, you can select the middle plane, that is this plane. Okay, and just click on OK. Okay, so this is how you have to draw this second part. Okay, so first we have drawn, we will take a quick recap. So first we have drawn this and pad it, then just we have pad one more rectangle here, then we have drawn a step one again here, we have pad it, and then we have mirrored it. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4 different steps are required to model it. So it is like this only. Okay, okay, so thank you. This is all about this session 3. So if you like this video, please like, subscribe, comment, share our channel. Thank you very much.